indeed a privilege to be part of the International Youth Fellowship Program once again. This is the fourth time I took part in the International Youth Fellowship. I'm optimistic that you will have an enjoyable International Youth Fellowship World Cultural Camp of 2018. I've been asked to contribute to your proceedings today and offer each of you an insight of how best you have the talent you have through this RYF camp and the potential that you have, that is a hidden potential that you have, that you can see it yourself after these 3 days that you have that potential with you. I've always held the belief that youth are destined, are destined to greater things if only you set your sights to the right course of action and tenaciously and strive towards it. You need to set a goal, decide where you want to be in 5 years' time, and work towards your goal. In psychology, this is called visioning. You set your vision and focus on achieving it. It's also biblical. In Proverbs chapter 29, verse 18, it said that if you have vision in your life, you have vision, you will see what is prepared for you in the coming years. But for those who don't have that vision will perish. Only those who obey the law will be saved. So it's also biblical. You must have a target. You must have a vision. So you may not get there immediately, as there always be challenges along the way. You find your way to achieving your goals. Do not lose heart, as overcoming each challenge will build your character and experiences. The real challenge is not failing, but in how you return from your failure. We should not be afraid of failure. That is what letting the youth down, that we are afraid of failure. It only strengthens you, or strengthens us, and help us grow and learn from our failures. When you achieve your first goal, you set a new one, which is more challenging, and go for it. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce to you a new way of thinking about young people and what we as adults in our community can do to help young people succeed. Most of us as adults, we used and don't prepare our youths to become leaders of tomorrow. Most of the time, we don't have a vision for their future. I will use these two words, use and prepare. Wakayangataki, kena wakarotaki. Ondo tukuna na bi bunwa kedi ondo ngolkina. Kima mina sa angasetake, urana bilutek memuri, nersa wakarotaki rao. Some of you might have heard that the term positive youth development or community youth development before. So when you think about young people, adolescents or teenagers, what comes to your mind, especially to us adults? Most of the time we are inundated with negative news, events and statistics. We worry about young people, their behavior and pathways. On the other hand, we have expectation, hopes and goals for young people. We want to see them succeed, to become successful, productive adults. One day you'll become a head of a family. You'll need something to eat. You need a house to keep your family in. So this is time to look at that vision. We want characteristics, skills, attributes would you like to see? The question is, how do we get to those desired outcomes? Despite the challenges and risks young people face. One thing we as adults sometimes forget is that We face challenges, risks, and difficult situations as adolescents as well. They probably look a little different, maybe, but they were challenges nonetheless. Positive youth development is a philosophy or approach promoting to set of guidelines on how a community can support its young people so that they can grow up competent, healthy, and develop their full potential. The approach highlights positive, healthy outcomes in contrast to reducing negative outcomes, such as teen pregnancies, substance abuse, and violence. Although most parents have clear ideas what positive characters and behaviors they would like to see in their children, there is still a lack of clarity on what exactly positive outcomes that we have. Ladies and gentlemen, the Fijian government through the Ministry of Youth and Sports recognizes that it is essential to include youth as active participants in any youth development initiative. We are mandated by government to conduct non-formal education in the 5 training centers that we have, and we also conduct mobile training throughout settlements and the villages on whatever type of training that it is needed in that the resources that you have, the environment that you have. We come and tailor-made that training to suit what you need. So the division manager, we have 4 division manager, one at the north, at the western, the eastern, and one at central, where you can inquire for more details on how to get registered as a youth club and as an entrepreneur. You have to be partners in the process. You have, your involvement presents a great challenge for adults and charges us to rethink how we have engaged in planning and program development and implementation. The ministry also ensures that youth development strategies are aimed to all youths. We are the ministry for all youths. The aim is to create supportive and enriching environment for all youth, which lead to the desire and positive outcome as well as reduce negative outcomes. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, focusing on on positive youth outcomes represent a major shift in thinking for a long time. We have concentrated on preventing or fixing negative behaviors and outcomes. Along with that approach, we have reduced young people to problem delinquent. Identifying and building on your strength will engage and motivate you to learn and experience more. I have no doubt that you will be enriched in your experience during this World Camp, as you are taken through the world of heart and taught its importance. The National International Youth Fellowship will take you to understand the world of arts and mind lecture during this past day and the 2 days ahead training that we have. It trains young leaders of the next generation to have some globalized mind and directs them to have wholesome values through healthy international exchange. In 2015, the ministry sent 26 youths to Korea for 5 weeks under the International Youth Fellowship Program. Most of these youths were members of the youth training center at Valelebu. They participated in the World Cultural Dance. We saw them with the gold awards. They became second because the first that took the award was a professional performer from Philippines, the group from Philippines. In addition, these youths were exposed to mind lectures for the first time, and it was noted that the mind lectures were very effective in changing the heart and minds of the youths. The mind lecture contributed a lot to the achievement made during the 5 weeks program. Upon returning to Fiji, 20 out of the 26 from the National Youth Band were absorbed into the RFMAP band, apart from the music training at YTC Valelevo. A big contributing factor was the also impact of these mind lectures on these young lives, shaping them into well-disciplined and produce and productive individuals, which was recognized by RMF. We trusted you. You will ultimately identify your real potential, and you will embrace in all certainty that in each other's differences and overcome any difficulties and limitation and that you may experience. My education will provide you with a strong mindset to overcome problems that will meet you in your lives. You have to listen to academic classes that you will that are conducted and you will have. You have to listen to God's heart. You have to listen to your parents. And you have to listen to your leaders. Be obedient to the their moral values, their ethics. To become tomorrow's leader, be a diligent follower today. Due to smart devices, mobile phones, communication between people has vanished. Once I went home and saw my son and nephew sitting side by side, not even greet me because their figure were dancing on their mobile phones. I called out, hey, they raised their, why didn't you raise your hand when I come in or look at me or say hello to me? But nobody listens. They were both speaking to their friends via mobile phones. Their bodies were at the same place, but their hearts were not flowing together. And that is the main purpose of this day. When I was young, we would speak frequently with our family, listen, be obedient, learn wisdom from parents, grandparents, and leaders, and again, to become leaders of tomorrow, be a diligent follower today. With that said, I welcome you once again in the world-renowned friendly Fijian spirit, and may this event spell hope for future beaming with prosperity for us all.